Stephen's competition is Tommy.
I am sure some of the other contestants will, you know, have to take me with a grain of salt.
Oh my God.
But I'm a regular guy from the South Side of Chicago who's made good. I've been a fashion designer for my entire life, and I think fashion and food is related. It is a visual art form. My food is really pretty to look at. You have to eat with your eyes before you eat with your stomach. I don't like to be overconfident, but I'm the next MasterChef.
Welcome.
You know, Tommy's a great guy, but I didn't come here to play tiddlywinks. I came here to win, and I'm gonna do my best to do it.
I want that MasterChef apron more than I want a Chanel haute couture dress.
Great to see you both.
Thank you.
How old are you?
47.
I am the magical age of 53.
Stop
it. No way.
I'm not cut. It's all real.
Amazing.
I only have one wrinkle, and I sit on it.
So, gentlemen, you're both cooking your signature dish, which is pork. Battling it out for one apron. Your 30 minutes starts now. Tommy, tell me about your pork dish.
My dish is a sophisticated version of a pork ballotine. And then I want to decorate my plate. Pork can look kind of, you know, dull and boring. So I want to make sure that I bring some color and some artistry to the plate.
Just under 20 minutes to go.
Oh, help.
Tommy's tenderloin is raw in the center. I think he might be done.
You think?
He can pull this back, get an onto pan on, and sear it, right? Kiss it.
Yep.
Last 60 seconds, come on.
Oh my God. Come
on, guys, let's
come
go.
On. Come on, guys. 10, 9, 8.
Oh God, help.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands in the air.
Good job, guys.
Both of you, well done. Okay, bring your dishes down to the front, please. Tommy, describe your dish, please.
It's a pork ballotine that is stuffed with fennel, zucchini, and Granny Smith apple with fennel fronds.
I got really nervous when you sliced that tenderloin because it was raw. Are you confident it's cooked in the middle? The tenderloin is cooked perfectly. It's moist. You got that sear around the outside. I'm amazed you got it cooked. Good job.
It's really, really tasty. Plating-wise, you've got stems of the fennel, you've got the fronds, you've got a sage leaf. It's nice that you're showing some of that artistry, but you need to dial it back.
The fennel fronds actually bring a really great, unexpected freshness to the dish. Really great effort.
Thank you.
Tough, two pork dishes, two very energetic, talented individuals. Stephen's filling.
Filling's good.
Tommy's was a mess. 4 minutes to go, it was raw, so I'm amazed he pulled that back.
Right.
I know. I know. You both did a really great job. Which one of these pork dishes wins this apron? The apron goes to...
Disappointed that I didn't win, but Tommy, he was a great competitor. He had a great dish, better than mine, and he ended up winning the apron. Congratulations to him.
Get ready. I'm not leaving. Buckle up your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy ride. My food is just like my fashion. It is a surprise. It's delicious. It's also visually appealing. And entertaining. It's hot in here. Or is that just me?
It's a kitchen, you donut.
You are smoking.
Tommy is just a friendly person. He's a bird that won't stop chirping.
I'm absolutely flabbergasted and gobsmacked.
Tommy's very showy and very extravagant.
I'm having another out-of-the-body experience right now. I am levitating.
Tommy is gonna be Tommy whenever the hell he wants to be Tommy, and he doesn't want to hear.
There's only one apron, and God made me to show those other ones how to wear it.
I know that Tommy is well-versed, has been around the world.
I have this incredible glossary that I make up words, you know, like transmetamorphiatric.
Yeah, Tommy's way over there. Tommy is off the reservation.
Julia Child, look down upon me now. Gastronomicus Rex, you know.
He's just obsessively talking.
I am usually flawless with communication. People pay me to talk. I've got enough talent to spread out here like an oil slick.
He's telling me you have to communicate in the kitchen. I say I know that only when it's relevant.
Yeah, maybe I should have used another word. I like to call my food and fashion edutainment. He is antagonizing every pore on my body. Vibrant, intense, intensity in a pot. That's me. Somebody please call the fire department. Food should be fun. We should enjoy food. Soul food.
Simple for Tommy is crazy for everybody else. Who knows what he's gonna do with
it. I'm letting these good times roll, honey, right to the finish line. Oh my God, Tommy Walton is just crazy. I know. Have you seen his eyes? It's as big as silver dollars. Look at his eyes long enough, you'll turn to stone like a gorgon.
Tommy, you look like you're dressed for the occasion.
Yeah, you look.
Thank you. Thank
you. You look like Prince.
Prince looks like me. I'm in the top 9, baby. That feels great, but it's also really scary.
Let's go, guys. Welcome.
There are 8 people here besides me who want to be Master Chef. I'm gonna have to stop these children. Getting another cooking demonstration from Gordon, Graham, and Christina is a magical treat.
You know what's at stake. The winner gets a huge advantage in the pantry. Is everyone ready to light this place on fire?
Yes, Chef.
Woo! Yes, Chef.
I'm so glad that I'm not the only thing flaming in this kitchen tonight. Hi. Voilà.
Tommy, bonsoir. Tout va bien?
Bonsoir. C'est très bien aussi.
Right, what are you doing?
I'm going to do one of the famous things from the French Quarter, which is bananas Foster.
Looks like tonight you're going back to your roots, southern Louisiana.
I'm trying to. You know, this has got a lot of drama in it, and I always love to bring the drama to the dinner table.
I would never have guessed that.
No. How's that?
Huh?
Yes.
Good luck.
2, 1, and stop.
Woo!
Hands in the air.
Please, step forward. Tommy.
Oh. Ha! Yes, baby. I've been called first. The judges are gonna be quite impressed today with Tommy Walton.
That looks beautiful. Describe the dish, please.
It is a bananas Foster with maple and bourbon cream, garnished with Granny Smith apples.
Inside is what?
Inside is a sweetened cream cheese with the banana inside.
It smells incredibly fragrant, and you haven't just done the sort of cheap flambé because the whole crepe is colored beautifully. Wow. It's rich, it's sumptuous, it's steeped in alcohol, but you've just burnt off the right amount of liqueur. I love what you've done with the saviness of the cream cheese inside as well. Tommy, delicious.
Merci beaucoup. Katrina's dish looks beautiful. And Stephen's dish looks like we're taking a walk in his garden. But I know my mama would love this bananas Foster. And my mama is telling me my baby's got this one.
chicken and waffles.
People don't think that I'm a Southern boy, but the truth is, I'm Creole, honey. I love chicken and waffles more than church loves sin.
Right, Tommy, how you doing?
I'm doing okay, chef. Thanks for asking.
Tell me about this. What's going on?
I'm doing a duck fat fried chicken.
Whose recipe is that?
That's my recipe. It can be yours, too, you know.
And next up, Tommy.
Oh. I'm really happy with this dish. My chicken wings, my chicken drumsticks, they look like solid gold.
Describe the dish, please.
Duck fat fried chicken with a pecan quinoa corn waffle and a tomato whiskey marmalade.
Why duck fat?
My Aunt Lorraine and my grandmother always kept a little coffee can of duck fat in the back of the stove that was saved. Nothing went to waste.
Chicken. Incredible. Waffles, another league. It's authentic, it's delicious. You're frying duck fat, which is a chef's dream. I think this is one of your best dishes that you've performed so far. And you may look the part, but now you can really cook the part.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Tommy. Let's go.
I can't believe what the judges are wearing. Gordon Ramsay was made to wear blue jeans.
Tell me about this dish, because you got all fancy. Where do these ideas come from?
I don't know. It's just some of the things that my students actually bring for me to lunch.
Right. Is that a weighing scale you've got on your fingers? What is that thing?
It's a gyroscope.
Have a quick look, please. A gyroscope. Doesn't that weigh your hands down?
No, it's quite light.
It's quite light?
Yeah, I can handle heavier than that weight. You'll see. I've got other jewelry.
Like what?
Oh, you'll see. Something that is reminiscent of one of the queens, you know.
Oh, I see.
Uh-huh. Now you can say you know more than one queen.
No. Do you have your belly button pierced?
No, I don't.
No.
No piercings on me.
No, okay, glad to hear it. Eyebrows, ears?
No.
No, thank God for that. Nor have I.
No.
Do you have any tattoos?
No, I don't.
No.
I won't defile my body.
Why not?
Because I have to stay fresh. I have to stay young.
Even
I have to stay new.
At 52, you've got skin of a 22-year-old.
Oh, that's okay.
What moisturizer do you use?
Champagne.
Can I try some?
Yes, I'll give you some.
Because how come I've got more wrinkles than you and I'm like 10 years younger than you?
I don't know. I don't go outside in the daytime, just like Dracula.
Tonight, I think you brought it. It tastes authentic. It looks good. Focus on the food, because when you cook like this, you're a dream.
Thank you, chef.
And I want Tommy the dream. I want to wake up with you. Not with you. No.
The truth comes out.
I want to wake up the next day remembering how good you can cook.
Yeah. There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Man.
Gordon Ramsay loves my dish so much, he wants to wake up with me. Gordon Ramsay, you are such a bad boy. Stephen, I need your sauce. Do you think you may want to slice these in half?
I don't know. This is your plate.
Okay.
Tommy, speed up.
Almost finished.
Tommy, tell me what you're doing so I know.
I'm trying to plate these plates and get these plates out.
Tommy, we gotta hurry up.
And all I can hear is, Tommy, don't, Tommy, please.
Okay. Push it faster, Tommy.
Don't. Oh, God.
Last minute, guys.
Tommy, fight. So push it, please.
Listen, we can't have this up here.
Okay.
Can you guys get that plate together in 1 minute? Tell me the truth.
Yes, I'm getting it.
Tommy, hurry up.
It's like three wild dogs in the yard barking and barking and biting at each other.
Tommy, don't stop moving. You can't do that fast enough. Let me know. I'll do it.
Do you know what I have to say to that?
Tommy,
faster.
Tommy, can you?
Shut up. That's right. Shut up.
Tommy, you came into this competition with flair, panache, a man that is a proper foodie, a true gourmand. And I think we'll remember you forever.
Wow. I'm sad to leave because I've met some of the most talented people standing up here in the balcony. And some of the dumbest people on this balcony. And I wish them all the best of luck.
Right, come over here.
cook with me the rest.
One day.
I'll see you in Chicago.
Exactly.
I'll miss you.
Bye, Christina.
Bye, Tommy.
Up there, one of them's going to become America's next MasterChef. In your mind, who's going to win it?
The future belongs to those who have the vision to see it.
So who is it?
Derek.
Wow.
Thank you, Tommy.
Tommy, you've been an angel.
Thank you, Chef.
Love it.
I feel absolutely blessed that I was a part of this MasterChef journey. Coming here as a fashion designer, I was gonna do all fancified, Europeanized versions of food.
Voila!
But it took me to come all the way here to MasterChef for me to go back home.
Have you got all country on us now?
I am country.
Congratulations, Tommy.
But the most incredible experience of all was having Gordon, Graham, and Christina as mentors.
This right there is one of the best panna cottas I think we've ever had in the MasterChef kitchen.
This, I really think, is the heart and the soul of why you're here and what makes you such a real contender in this kitchen.
When you cook like this, you dream. And I want to wake up with you. Not with you. No. I want to wake up the next day remembering how good you can cook.
I'm used to being misunderstood my entire life. I've always had to explain to everybody why I am the way I am.
How's that?
Huh?
Yes.
But here, I know that I've got to represent myself truthfully and be who I am, which is a big, bright, shiny, multifaceted disco ball.
Exit of all time.